Hello, welcome back. I hope you're doing very well. After my last workflow tutorial video, I got quite a few comments from people saying they'd like to see something that went into a bit more depth or detail on the subject of performing with the force. That's quite a big subject, so I've decided to chop it up into different chunks. And in this first one, we're going to look at what I think is probably the most important subject, which is variations within a performance. I'll put some time codes in the description so you can jump around, but that's enough intro. Let's get on with it. So the idea here is to create some variations that are easy to perform. That's the sort of main focus. To get us started off, I've created a little bass line here. Now, the way the force works, it's very easy to create a drum track like we've done here, chuck a kit on it and create a pattern. Very easy to do. And that's exactly what I've done in this first scene. Sounds perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with that. From a performance point of view though, it's a bit awkward and it has a few downsides. The primary one being that if you want to perform by muting drum pads in and out, you have to be in note mode with the track armed, and then it's a case of using two fingers, which is a little bit awkward. Now, of course, you can create custom macros if you want to mute specific pads in and out, but you might want to have those knobs and pads set up for other things. So what we're going to do is look at a way of doing it slightly differently, which sounds better, I think, as well. So I've created another scene which has the same bass line and the same kit in it, but this time from this kit I've only got the kick drum playing, which is going to come eventually, which you can hear there. Now on these two tracks, I've got these are audio tracks, and in each one I've got a loop playing. The first one, this one here, is a top loop, which is just, sorry, that was something falling off my desk, which is hi-hats basically, and then a second loop, which is a snare loop playing, and they're just playing in continuous loops, and it sounds like this. Now if we switch between the two, now I think that sounds more interesting. One of the reasons it does is because these are samples of real drums playing, they've got slight timing kind of imperfections, for want of a better term, which gives them some nice swing and a little bit of groove, but they've also got some nice textures as well. But from a performance point of view, if we're in mute mode, it's really easy to create variations in a performance, build ups, drop downs, that sort of thing, just by using your mutes and your left hand. And it leaves all of your other pads free for, sorry, your knobs free for other macros. And it's just really easy to do. And there's nothing you can get wrong, really, because they all work together. They sound right if they're all in. And dropping them in and out always sounds good. Now, as a sort of bonus tip, if we look at the mixer here and go to the I/O tab, you'll see that these three drum tracks, the kick, the top loop, and the snare loop, instead of having them go to the main out, I've got them sent to a submix, the same submix. If we look at that, which I've named Drum Bus, and then go to Effects, you'll see that I've put a compressor on it. Now, the reason I've done that is basically it turns that into a drum bus, and that parallel compression over all of those drum parts glues them all together, and it just makes them sound better, and it's just a bit of good mixing practice. If you're playing live, you can send the drums out to a different bus as well if you want to. Anyway, moving on, that was an easy way to create some rhythmic variation. We're now going to take a look at some melodic variation. I've duplicated this scene, and I've added in this track here just a little simple synth line, which is a hype synth preset, and it sounds like this. It's a bit quiet. Let's turn that up a bit. As you heard, that's quite a long sustained sound, and it takes up quite a lot of space. So what we want to do is create a variation of that, which is a bit shorter and a bit more rhythmic. So what we're going to do is copy the entire track, which we do by holding copy, pressing the track number, and then pasting into a new track. Now what that's done is copy all of the information, not just the instrument, but also the MIDI clip that's in there as well. We're now going to solo that track so we can listen to just our new synth line. So what we're going to do is edit that to make it sound different. And we do that by holding edit and track select, which brings up the UI. We're now going to go to the filter and amp page. In the amp section, we're going to dial down the sustain and the decay. And we've immediately turned that from a long sustaining sound into a short clicky sort of sound. We're now going to go to the effects page and we're going to dial in some more delay mix and some more reverb mix. Now that sounds a little bit quiet. By taking some of the body of that sound out, we've lost some volume. So we're just going to go to the mixer and turn it up a little bit. Sounds good. So what we've done there is create two variations of a rhythmic, of a melodic sound, and three drum tracks that we can bring in and out. So if we switch over to, let's go back to unsolo that new track we've just created. If we go back to mute mode and mute that track we've just created, and we've now got our original arrangement. So if we play that, sounds as it did before. Now at any point, we can just take out our sustain sound and bring in the clicky one. It's still a bit too quiet, so let's bring the volume up on that. That sounds better. We can revert back. Incidentally, when I copied this track over and duplicated it, if you're worried about track counts, you could have just copied the clip into a new slot on the existing track and change those parameters on the effects and the amp envelope using automation. But obviously, if you do that, to switch between them, you need to switch between the clips. You can't do it with the mutes. So anyway, we've now got our bass line, which is, we're not messing around with. We've got our three tracks of drums and our two synth variations. And we can basically just mess around bringing stuff in and out with the mutes. And because they all slot together, it will sound okay whatever we do. So let's have a quick go at that. So everything in. We can now create a drop down by taking out our hi-hat loops and switching to the clicky sound. Now we can bring our snare back in our hats, then bring the original bass, synth back in. So as you can see, you can do pretty much anything with your left hand and these mutes, and it will sound okay whatever you do. And because it's just a one-handed operation, that leaves your other hand free to do other parameter changes, to play instruments if you have the keyboard or note mode set up. It's just a really versatile way of very easily creating variations in a performance. Anyway, I hope that was useful. There'll be some more of these tip videos coming. So if you haven't subscribed, please do. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.